How do I find it on here? Am I following myself? No. Oh, there it is. There's the dashboard I go to. Okay. I think it's going. I believe it's going. Can I see the actual stream? Hello? I think it's up and running. Everything seems to be saying that it's up and running. If I could just, you know, maybe. Just gonna verify real quick, cause my phone's not finding Jack Diddley, and Jack Diddley is not a good amount to not be finding. Wait, what? I have no idea what I just said. Okay, if I go to my channel here, is it running? It's running.
Hey everybody.
It's running here. Why isn't it running on my phone? Phone, what are you doing?
Russell, that sounds like garbage.
Not even close. Yankee Doodle.
Okay, phone, do you wanna show up? It's clearly up and running. I could hear it. Okay. Oh, there we go. Now it's there. Thank you, phone. Took you long enough. Okay, anyways, everybody, I'm sorry about all of that trying to figure out if it's up and running, and then eventually finding out it is up and running and verifying and bleh. Anyways, I am DurchBurch for those of you who don't know and are here already or are watching this on, you know, a replay thing, like a past broadcast type situation or YouTube and all that. But anyways, I'm going to be playing some Heroes of the Storm. None of my friends is online playing right now, so I'm probably just going to do some... Well, actually, I want to check. Is the Brawl new? This is a new Brawl. Okay. Okay. Okay, I guess I'm going to do the Brawl again. This is... Yeah, that's right. It's been a week since the last stream, so it's it's gonna be Brawl time again. So while I wait for the Brawl to find me, while I wait for the game to find me a nice Brawl, you know, what's going on with my life right now is Pokemon, basically. Been playing Sun and, or not Sun and Moon. I've just been playing Moon. I only own Moon. I don't want Sun. I've been playing Moon, and actually my brother just messaged me and it reminded me of something disgusting that happened. A Grimer used Harden, and I didn't remember that Grimer could learn Harden, and that's just, there's something more disgusting about the fact that it's a pile of like radioactive feces that in Moon eats garbage. And then that pile of radioactive feces that eats garbage then hardens. It's like, ugh. But hopefully my internet connection wants to be nice and friendly for us all. And you never know. Especially on this college campus. It's variable. Luckily there's a potluck going on tonight. I think somewhere around my building, so people might not be here, taking all my bandwidth. Usually upload speeds are good, so it wouldn't really affect you guys, just me. Oh, that's nice. Nice. Hello, everyone. Burr, burr, burr. Give me a kiss. I recently found out I can actually spin other people's characters. so I should try that out at some point.
Ready yourselves promptly.
So are we on...
The battle commences in 10 seconds.
We're on defense.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go and gather the cannonballs quickly. I want to hear those cannons thundering.
Oh yeah, I'm like, man, we're on defense. Why are we doing the cannonballs? Okay. Ah, crap, I was about to get my shield up, too. It was the fact that they had one, like, in a new rack as well, and he dug and stunned me. So that was lame. And with them now, I'm going up here. That way they can continue to distract everyone down below. Oh, hey. Crap. Go, baby, go. There you are, okay. Okay, everybody just needs to stay safe and smart. That's good.
Blackheart's halfway to the docks. We need to stop him.
Darn it. This map is harder than it looks.
Excellent work, defenders. Blackheart's ship has taken significant damage.
I mean, I'm doing decently tanking, but that's because I'm dying constantly. Tanking. I'm gonna get you. Guess I'm not gonna get you. Yeah, that was a waste of that. Where can I get the cannonball? Then collect the ammo! Okay. That was... that was Interesting. That was actually my first time, like, ever playing that mode, and I didn't really read much about it beforehand, so now that I have an idea of it, I can go into it much more intelligently and actually strategize. I just kind of was like, oh, grab the balls, put the... I died. Where is the can? Where are the balls? What do I do? I died. So hopefully this time, things will go a bit better, and I won't just die. And I won't just be like, oh, where does everything happen? What do I do? Also, hopefully I'll be on the attack side at some point, because that will be interesting. And people are being very noisy in the hallway. I can hear them through my headphones. I mean, they're just earbuds, but you know, I have some awesome Heroes of the Storm Brawl music going on in my ears, and I hear like laughter. This displeases me. I don't like hearing laughter. Laughter's not my jam. Yeah. Having fun there, Blackheart. Just standing. What do you think of with your probably... What do you have a brain? He's a skeleton. He's a skeleton who's undead. So would he really be a ghost possessing his skeleton? Why am I trying to think scientifically? It's a ghost pirate. There's no science behind that. It's a pirate who is dead and stuff. So I'm gonna... Let's see, how much time is it? Yeah, it's probably gonna be a little while. So I'm gonna... Or not. I was gonna tell you guys my Pokemon Moon team at this time. But that looks like that's not happening. So let's see what's going on now. Okay. Got a nice little group here. Oh! Okay, I'm on protect the ship time. Okay. Awesome. I was wondering when I'd get one of these. These defense lines. I have so much stubble right now. It's very nice. Because I had to shave off my goatee. I now get stubble there too. Ooh, it's taking long to... I'm guessing somebody dropped. 12 out of 10. I actually know who's yelling right now. If you were yelling loud enough for me to actually acknowledge who... To understand who you are by your voice, you need to quiet down. Especially. I'm gonna do this. Okay, I'll go Rainer. I can't be a good raider, but I can do my best to be a good raider. Can I spin them? I can spin them, see? This is what I'm talking about. And if we overlap at the time, I can spin both of us. You having fun there?
Get out there! And don't let them fire those cannons at me ship.
Okay, so we're gonna have most of us try to go top. Ha ha ha. Oh, we can switch sides.
Raiders roll.
Okay, so that's what that is. I'm dead.
Your killing spree be
over. Samurai's dead. Falstad's dead.
Just never get used to that. You can count on me.
Raise our impact.
It's not a hard map to really understand. I didn't really get it my first time.
Ship's in rough shape. She can't take much more.
But it's not a hard map, per se.
You can count on me.
Defeat? No, I don't think so.
Couldn't explain it to them. It's not that hard to understand. You just have to actually look at the health. You know, you have to get the ship to a distance. They have to not let... you have to get the ship to a distance. They have to shoot you with 5 cannonballs. It's very easy for them if the other side, or if the other side doesn't know what they're doing. Basically, what everyone seemed to be doing was just running around attacking them and ignoring where the cannons were and where the cannonballs were after a few minutes. It's like, just stay where the cannonballs are, and then when there's not much cannonballs, just stay where the cannons are. If people could stop slamming the door right next door. It's always the one right next door. I don't know why they always slam it. That's the only door that I ever hear get slammed. Oh yeah, I was gonna tell you guys my moon team, so. Alrighty, let me bring this little guys up. Okay. So, my starter was Rowlet. His name is Robin Hoot. Not the best nature, I would say. Special defense is increased, attack is decreased. Especially considering that Decidueye has slightly higher attack, I think. But that's not that big a deal, considering it's pretty close, if I remember correctly. So it's not going to be that far off. So it's like, whatever. Then I've got Broadside, my pick-a-peck. Named that because it's going to be a 2-cannon. Decreased speed, increased special defense. Not bad, actually, because 2-cannon has 75 special defense, special attack, and defense. 60 speed's not that great anyways. Having boosted speed won't matter. It's better to just be bulky against something that's going to hit you for more damage and still be able to deal your normal type of damage. Then I got Buggles, the Letty Bomb. Buggles is probably the worst one on the team. Lowered special attack, increased speed. Speed is decent for Ledian, and so it's not that big a deal to have lowered speed, or to have increased speed, but it's a big deal to have lowered special attack, because that's its only good attack stat. Which honestly, there's no good attack set on. It's 55-35. 55 being special attack, so it's like, I mean, they both suck, so who cares? And so, I mean, it's just going to be a speedy tank. I'm going to try and have more support moves on it that it gets. Then I've got Flugel the Second, my Wingull, which is named after my deceased Flugel the Wingull of Pokemon Ruby, the Dirtlock Challenge on the Pokemon News YouTube channel. Now, Flugel the Second has lowered speed and increased special attack, which isn't that bad, because Pelipper's not crazy fast, but its special attack is decent, and getting a boost to that just sounds awesome to me. I'm all for it. I've got Auto Zone with a Magnemite, because it's going to be a Magna Zone. It's like, huh, zones, and Auto Zone makes sense, and yeah. But Auto Zone, he's there, special defense for defense isn't that bad. Honestly, it would probably be better the other way around. And then I've got Nurmal, the Alolan Meowth. Don't have time to tell you guys the stats on it. I'm gonna probably do, but I already closed the screen. It's like, eh. I don't feel like going back through the menus. I don't know, my only major complaint is that it's so much harder to play with friends. The PSS was so well organized and so useful for that, and Festival Plaza is not. Festival Plaza is the only thing I don't like about the game. It's like, what was it, Join Avenue in Pokemon Black and White 2. Oh, I'm not really good with any of these characters. Poop. I know Brightwing's good. Let's see what Brightwing's like. Well, I guess I'm Uther now. I went to look at him and I'm like, well, don't have much time, better lock in, and then it just locked in for me, so.
The battle is about to begin. Ready yourselves promptly.
Hello.
Divine Storm, damage and stun nearby enemies, divine shield. Seconds. I don't know, I feel like Divine Storm would be really nice. Especially on this map. Okay, well, I greatly underestimated how that one works. Oh, that was a good fear. Oh, what Illidan thought he was doing. I happened to hit Nova with that. What are you doing, Redeve? Why did you stay? There you go. I got you, bro.
firing.
Beautiful.
Right, your ship is almost done for. So much for your revenge, Blackheart.
Let's see. We can do this. Only 75%. I know.
No, he's almost to the docks. Fire those cannons already.
Feel the hatred of 10,000 years.
Yes. GG. That was beautiful. Okay. Well, that was actually much faster than the last time, because the last time, I believe, was round-based. So, as this one's not round-based, I will continue by playing other things as well, or other modes. Nice. Got all that gold. Okay. The easy way through all that is to just play ranked, because I get all three of these for playing ranked. I have no friends to play with right now, so I am all alone, and I'm probably not going to get that Genji skin because I'm not going to have much time, considering next week I have... Yeah, next week I have Thanksgiving break, and I'm not going to have access to my computer there. And then I have the holiday break in December, which I might bring my computer with me if I need it. So I might get a chance then to just bash through some matches with my brother real quick. but yeah, that would be really a tight kind of like squeeze to get that all done. So playing ranked, there's a much longer wait time between matches, but that's not that bad. Also, it'd be kind of cool if they actually released this dude as a character, like Hologram Man, as like the Heroes of the Storm, representative in Heroes of the Storm, but that would be stupid. It's like, what would he do? He's a hologram man. He does other things and stuff. I would love to play Team League. I just don't have enough friends who play Heroes of the Storm. I have like my brother and he has his friends who play one of my friends on campus. There's not that many people who play, like, you know, none of these people play. Jacob doesn't play. Jacob, my buddy from Pokemon News, he doesn't really have much time, considering he's a music ed major, or at least his planned major is music ed. He has a lot of band obligations and a lot of class obligations. This one's so all or nothing with a good team. Or a bad team. Like, it's like, you go and you either run or lose. I'm open to suggestions. Samuro it is. Varian has not been nerfed yet. Godan. I might make Godan my second ban. there goes Varian. Anubarak is awesome. Play Anubarak.
For the frozen throne.
Okay.
Zarya, ready for duty.
Don't you pick Godan Cynatilapia? With a what? I don't know. What is it? What? People's names sometimes, they're like so weird. And you never know where they come from. It's like, just there. It's their name. They chose. Oh. I like that skin. I think I should get some Nazebo action in.
I hear the call.
I haven't had a good Nazebo. A good Nazebo game.
They went home.
So they're gonna pick their ban. And who is it gonna be? Who are you banning? Make your pick, bro, or you're not gonna get a ban. Muradin. Why would you ban a tank? We already have a tank. Are we gonna go double tank? Double CC tank? Actually, Muradin's got some CCs and a CC tank. Mouth's less of a problem now, so I'm not gonna ban him. Like, he's legitimate, he's just so much less of a problem. Or I wouldn't say so much less, he's just less of a problem. He's less wanted because of his nerfs. I mean, they sounded like light nerfs, but they were a bit substantial. I mean, they like entirely. Or not entirely, but they hurt his ability to be a solo, or not a solo lane, but like a pusher. Like, his push build involved Moonburn, and they nerfed Moonburn hard. Or I wouldn't say hard, they lowered it to 75% bonus damage instead of double damage. I think it was 75. It's like, that's not good enough. His Moonfire was already terrible damage. You can't lower the damage on that. Oh wow, I'm up against a gold 5. That's the first gold 5 I've ever played against. It's the first gold I've ever played against. Why are you playing against silver 4, bro? Seriously. Dizzy Rogue, what's wrong? I'm kind of regretting banning, or not banning ETC. Because their gold has ETC. Dang. I also don't like how quiet this team was during the banning and picking phases. Like, you gotta communicate. You can't just leave the ban leader and one other person communicating. You gotta have, you know, you gotta have votes. Like, who should we ban? I'm thinking about this character. And then they all go, oh, how about this character, this character, this character? And everyone's like, oh, okay, yeah, let's ban. Let's ban this one. You know, we seem to have a general consensus for that character, and so, you know, that character gets banned and people go on with their lives. But no. We're just gonna have three people sit in silence. on the five-man team. It's like, this isn't a team if we all just sit there and do nothing, you know? You know? Just ain't a team. I just realized that there's a hole there. Huh.
Systems online.
I never quite realized this was a floating station. I mean, it's not illogical. There's a lot of levels like that in StarCraft.
Two, one. Gates open.
Time for action.
Why do we have both of the specialists going, but... I don't know, Brightwing. I picked mine first, and then it just kind of happened that we had another one. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Yeah, you don't want to hit Zarya when the shield's up.
The beacons are energizing. You have to control them.
Oh, hi. Like, I can't do anything down here, guys. There's two of them. One with hard CC. And one that's just... like, impossible. Okay, we got this. Oh great, we've got an annoying Illidan. Come here. Good job, Illidan. I mean, at least you're functional. Okay, I'm gonna hold this one. Oh, great. course there's no fountain here anymore. It's like, I could use some mana, please. Okay. There's some intenseness going on in this bush. Oh, crap, what are you doing staying in there? I had to pull my thing down already. What's that? It's like, if there's a clump of enemies, don't stand next to them when you're playing with Nazebo on your team. Like, it's just wisest that you don't. I need mana again. We are, like, so far behind in experience right now. Why would you go to me? Why would you do that? That was a bad idea. I mean, you saved my life, but you lost a ton of health. Gargantuan. Bail, guys. It's a good time to fall back. Okay, we've got it. I died, but we took the thing. I mean, my My siege damage is doing real nice. But it's like still nothing compared to their teams. I love how they were like complaining about how we had two specs, and it's like the specs have the highest siege and hero damage on the team. It's like, we have a freaking Illidan on the team. How are the specs doing better? Got it, bro. Good job, Evan. What, my health was low, what am I supposed to do? Last time I checked, I have higher hero damage than you, so shut up. For your lives.
The way is clear.
I didn't have a good spot where I could just hearth, so. That's right, you run away. Bring a poison, finally. Get some damage up in there. Up in that zombie ring. Okay, let him engage nice and early. And then what was that? What the hell was that? You engaged early and then you just left. The only reason I had to engage was because you did.
Killing spree.
sit here and build some stacks. I'm gonna come down here and join the bot push. I don't know if I clicked on the map or if it was clicking while scrolling, but I ended up turning and running into that too much. Yeah, I don't know if I should take any orders from Illidan. My hero damage is 4,000 higher. Siege damage, 60,000 higher. Actually, it's more like 70,000 higher. Yeah, 61,000 higher. I don't know what I was thinking. Yeah, like, I have 61,000 higher siege. You know, I have crazy decent, pretty decent hero damage. And I have highest experience contribution. I have 3 deaths total. He has 5. It's like, smart Illidan doesn't die that many times. And get that little damage going. So, like, he should be way above me in damage. Get Fluffy Kins on there. That was quite the GG. I like how their Gina came back and was just like,
"Victory!
Oh, I'm all alone. I've lost."
MVP.
Oh, I did not even get there. So let's take a look at the stats at this end game. don't know, I'm not a huge fan of that battleground. It's cool, it's fun, but it's not amazing. My average takedown count is 4.9 as Nazebo? Really? 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 That is... Actually, I guess that makes sense. Nazebo's not known for getting crazy numbers of kills. It is just that map, kind of, you need it. And also, that gave us the Sylvanas, who had the chance to, you know, do everything else, pretty much. Let's see. Yeah, that was a large chunk of our team siege damage. Even, like, the Sylvanas basically got most of her experience contribution from having second highest siege damage and from having highest hero damage. Illidan was 20,000 behind her in hero damage. There is no excuse. She is a Sylvanas. Sylvanas is not known for hero damage. Sylvanas is known for strong siege. I'm happy with my highest experience contribution on the team. You know, 1,000 higher than our other spec. And I think that was the most important thing for us, was that we had two specialists that were able to work together to basically, you know, achieve a very strong experience push when we stopped dying constantly. And I mean, Sylvanas died quite a few times. 7 deaths for that much of all of these is amazing. Though I feel that Sylvanas died probably the most at the beginning. But yeah, our Illidan wasn't bad. I've seen worse Illidans. But to put it in perspective, one of my friends, my one campus friend who plays Heroes of the Storm, doesn't play it often. He plays Illidan because he can just spam, like, he can literally just mash QWE, until he gets his heroic, and then just smash QWER, and he will win matches. Like, he only pretty much plays Illidan because Illidan's so easy. I think he also plays... I think Muradin was his other one? But yeah, he doesn't... Like, he plays characters where you can just mash buttons and things happen. And Illidan is one of those characters. It's like... To be an Illidan that gets 7 kills isn't hard. To be one that gets 5 deaths and 7 kills and 8 assists is okay. Like... It's not that impressive, but the only major issue I had with him was that he was, you know, being a douche nozzle. Like, it's like, what are you doing, Illidan? It's like, you had second lowest experience contribution. You know, Illidan's not known for high experience contribution, but I mean, come on. Come on. What are you doing with your life? I'm gonna check. Are there any heroes I can buy for 2,000 right now that are, you know, ones that I've kind of played and enjoyed and stuff? I kind of like Jaina, the one time I played her, but she's 4,000. Diablo's 2,000, but I've never played Diablo. The character and the game. I've never played any of the Diablo series. Kind of interesting to think of. Huh. It's like the only ones that are 2,000 are like the not so good ones. And the really, really old ones, like the original set. Come on. I mean, there's ETC. ETC is good. But I've never played him. I mean, I might as well buy him, I guess. I have the money, and I still have over 10,000. So yeah, I've got ETC now. Good for me. But yeah, that was a good Nazebo. That was a good Nazebo round. I'm proud of that. I mean, I didn't get any of the special things at the end, but I didn't need it. I mean... I'd got so much higher than my average when it comes to you know, kills, apparently. Like, you know, I averaged, like, 5 and I got 16. That's insane. And that's not just kills and assists. I'm pretty sure that was overall. I mean, for those of you who are watching this back, you know, you can take a look. You can see, you know, the exact number. Like, that was pretty impressive to me. I mean, I don't know if I got actually 16 overall, like, assists and kills, or if that was just my kills or what. I didn't really pay attention when I was there to that, but you know, I still averaged 5 total, so getting, you know, that much is actually really impressive, and I'm happy with that. You know, at the end of the day, the way to judge how good you are or how well you played that day is, are you happy with how you played? Were you happy with your losses? Or at least how well you did when you lost? You know, were you happy with, you know, like, were you happy? You know, that's like, that's the main question. That's what you have to determine. You know, at the end of the day, what it comes down to is not, you know, did you win? It's, are you happy with how you played? Like, I'm trying to think, that's something that I guess could apply to life as well. Like, you know, you might make a ton of money at a job you hate, but are you going to feel satisfied in life? No, because at the end of the day, you aren't happy with what you did that day. So, like, regardless of money, do what makes you feel happiest. Do that and be a happy person because of that. You know, like, it's hard to be depressed when you do what you love. And if you are so depressed when you do what you love, there's something else that's, you know, going on in your life that would be bringing you down like that. Or, you know, you just happen to have, you know, something neurologically or psychologically that's leading to that depression other than your life. But if you, you know, if you feel sad at the end of the day after work, and it's a job you love, you know, either you had a really bad day that day, or you're not, you know, there's something wrong. So, like, you know, you can apply that to, you know, games like this too. You know, if you play poorly and you know you played poorly, you're gonna feel kind of bad. But the thing is, if you played well, and even whether you lost or won, you're going to know you played well, and you're going to feel good about that. And that's one of the best feelings you can get, is, you know, like, that's kind of the reason you should not play games like this on bad days. Because if you play games like this on a bad day, and things go poorly, you know, and things don't go well, it's not going to be helpful. You know, you're just going to get madder and more upset. And it's harder to play well when you're already mad and upset. You gotta come into these kind of calmer, or ready to calm down, or knowing that there's the risk of, you know, getting worked up. But anyways, I want to thank everybody who's, you know, watched this, whether it was, you know, live, or, you know, watching it back on YouTube or Twitch. Thanks so much, for my YouTube peoples out there. Hi, it's good to see you guys are watching these too. And for my Twitch peoples out there, you know, thank you for watching and stopping by. I mean, I don't really, my Twitch is not my main thing, my YouTube channel is. My YouTube channels are kind of my main things. But you know, Twitch is a decent way for me to, you know, play games live. Some days I don't have, you know, the time that I really feel I want to take out to edit. I mean, today Pokemon Moon I picked up, you know, I've been playing that, and I want to keep playing that. It's hard to record and then edit and do all that for something that day. So, I mean, this, it's like, stream, you know, it takes an hour. An hour's recording might be 2-3 hours at least of editing. audio, video. You know, there's a lot that goes on for a relatively, or there's a lot more going on after recording than just what happens when recording, so it takes me a while to get videos up. And if I want to play a game during that time, you know, it's hard. So, you know, that's why I'm using Twitch every once in a while. It gives me a chance, especially because I'm in college now and I have homework and other obligations. I can't always record and edit. I don't always have that time, and I don't always have that luxury. So sometimes just streaming, uploading the stream to YouTube afterwards, you know, that's just, it works out much nicer and much friendlier. But anyways, I've been rambling for a while. Once again, thanks so much for watching. For anybody who's watched this, I'm going to be ending the stream in a second. So, bye everybody. Hope you've enjoyed it. Farewell.